Welcome to our celebration. In your green hymnal number 299, we'll begin this Thursday of the third week of Advent. Please rise.
Come, come, Emmanuel, Son of God, appear. Heaven and earth rejoice, salvation is drawing near. Salvation is drawing near. Come, come, Emmanuel, Son of God, appear. Heaven and earth rejoice, salvation is drawing near. Salvation is drawing near.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you always.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters who serve these sacred mysteries, we come before God asking for mercy and pardon. You are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Unworthy servants that we are, O Lord, grieved by the guilt of our deeds, we pray that you may gladden us by the saving advent of your only begotten Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Raise a glad cry, you barren one who did not bear. Break forth in jubilant song, you who are not in labor. For more numerous are the children of the deserted wife than the children of her who has a husband, says the Lord. Enlarge the space for your tent. Spread out your tent cloths unsparingly. Lengthen your ropes and make firm your stakes. For you shall spread abroad to the right and to the left. Your descendants shall dispossess the nations and shall people the desolate cities. Fear not, you shall not be put to shame. You need not blush, for you shall not be disgraced. The shame of your youth you shall forget. The reproach of your widowhood no longer remember. For he who has become your husband is your maker. His name is the Lord of hosts. Your Redeemer is the Holy One of Israel, called God of all the earth. The Lord calls you back like a wife forsaken and grieved in spirit, a wife married in youth and then cast off, says your God. For a brief moment I abandon you, but with great tenderness I will take you back. In an outburst of wrath, for a moment I hid my face from you, but with enduring love I take pity on you, says the Lord, your Redeemer. This is for me like the days of Noah, when I swore that the waters of Noah should never again deluge the earth. So I have sworn not to be angry with you, or to rebuke you, though the mountains leave their place and the hills be shaken, my love shall never leave you, nor my covenant of peace be shaken, says the Lord, who has mercy on you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response to this reading: I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me. I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me. I will extol you, O Lord, for you drew me clear and did not let my enemies rejoice over me. O Lord, you brought me up from the netherworld. You preserved me from among those going down into the pit. I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me. Sing praise to the Lord, you, his faithful ones, and give thanks to his holy name, for his anger lasts but a moment, a lifetime his good will. At nightfall, weeping enters in, but with the dawn, rejoicing. I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me. Hear, O Lord, and have pity on me. O Lord, be my helper. You changed my mourning into dancing. O Lord, my God, forever will I give you thanks. I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight his paths. All flesh shall see the salvation of God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. When the messengers of John the Baptist had left, Jesus began to speak to the crowds about him. What did you go out to see in the desert? A reed swayed by the wind? Then what did you go out to see? Someone dressed in fine garments? Those who dress luxuriously and live sumptuously are found in royal places. Loyal palaces. Then what did you go out to see? A prophet? Yes, I tell you, and more than a prophet, this is the one about whom Scripture says, "Behold, I'm sending my messenger ahead of you. He will prepare your way before you. I tell you, among those born of a woman, no one is greater than John, yet the least in the kingdom of God is greater than he." All the people listened, including the tax collectors, who were baptized with the baptism of John, acknowledged the righteousness of God. But the Pharisees and the scholars of the law, who were not baptized by him, rejected the plan of God for themselves. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today, as we listen to our first reading, there is a word that, or a sentence that I reflected about. And the sentence is an instruction that says, "The shame of your youth you must forget. The shame of your youth you must forget." In a sense, the Lord is telling us that our past must not torment us because we are looking to the future in Christ. That we must not be tormented by our past that is not so good, but place it before God because we are looking to the future with Christ. Then the answer comes in the psalm when he says, I'll praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me. That if we forget the past, the shame of our youth, because it has been taken away by Christ, therefore we come to him to give him praise. Why? Because he has rescued us. And that's the main purpose of the Christ that we are waiting for, to rescue his own people. That our past, that is sinful, must not torment us, but be forgotten and rejoice in the Lord. We praise him for his deliverance. We praise him for he has delivered us from our sinfulness. And then after that, we clothe ourselves in the Lord. And for those who walk with God, God invites more many others around him. When you look at the story of John the Baptist, when Jesus is asking them questions, what did you go to see? Somebody dressed very well in the desert? A prophet? What did you go to see? Indeed, a prophet. And he goes on to say, but there is a greater prophet than he whom you went to see in the desert. This is the one the scripture speaks about, that I'm sending one ahead of you to prepare a way before you. The Lord is telling us, I am he, look no farther. We are privileged as sons and daughters of God, Christians, that the Lord comes to us each and every day and says, look no farther, I am he. Therefore today, my call to you is praise your God always, for he has rescued you.
Praise your God always, for he has rescued you. Look no farther. That's what he's telling us. Look no farther. Here I am. Don't go around looking for somebody else, because I'm greater than the one you may be looking for. Here I am. I am he. The one who is being spoken of in the scriptures, the one who is spoken of in the commandments, the one we talk about, I am he. Look no farther. Hello? Look no farther. Don't be swayed by things that move, things that are not constant. Look no farther. He is with us always. Even today, he'll present himself at the altar and he'll be telling us, I am he. Look no farther. Are you worried about anything? Bring it to me. Are you concerned about whatever is going on in life? Bring it to me. Do you have any fears in life? Bring them to me. Look no farther. I am he. And let not your past torment you. Why? Because the Lord has rescued us. And therefore, we come before him to praise him. For he has rescued us. And we are not destitute. Look no. Look no. He is with us. May we continue praising him and thank him for everything that he has done to us. Give him the praise from deep down your hearts. May God bless you, and look no. And now we bring our petitions to the Lord, asking him to guide us, and as we praise him, may he reside in our hearts, always to guide us.
For church leaders, may the Lord continue to fill them with joy in their mission to radiate his love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the peace and salvation of all the world, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of those experiencing loneliness during the holiday season, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in our midst in need of material or spiritual help, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may they see the face of God this day, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of those special petitions and prayer needs that you hold within your hearts, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for our Mass intentions for today, for Jewel Newman, Tilly Persine, for all of the victims of the tornado in Kentucky, and for the Christmas novena, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And now join me in praying the prayer for vocations, which you can find in the back of the hymnals. God, in baptism you called us by name and made us members of your people, the church. Guide us to know our vocation in life and to respond by living your spirit of holiness. For your greater glory and for the service of your people, raise up dedicated and generous members who will serve their lives as women and men religious, priests, deacons, married or single. Send your spirit to guide and strengthen us so we may serve your people, following the example of your Son, Jesus Christ, in whose name we offer this prayer. Amen.
We also pray for the clergy and the priests that they may be guided by God's love to guide his people in truth and that love of God. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Turn to me, oh turn and be saved, says the Lord. For I am God, there is no other, none beside me. I call your name. I am God who comforts you, who are you to be afraid of flesh that fades, is made like the grass of the field, soon to wither.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord
accept the sacrifice at my hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of his church. Accept, we pray, O Lord, these offerings we make gathered from among your gifts to us, and may what you grant us to celebrate devoutly here below gain for us the prize of eternal redemption through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling, John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of the Nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so, with the angels and archangels, thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, O Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that in partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring all the fullness of charity, together with friends of our Pope, Gustav, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles, with all the saints, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise you and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. And now with praise that we have been delivered by our Lord, we pray to the Father in the words our Savior taught us, saying, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptations. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as you await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Lord Jesus Christ, who say to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. May we share that sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say a word and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Now, together with our brothers and sisters unable to receive the body of Christ, let us make a spiritual communion with them. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Most Holy Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Let every valley be filled. Let every valley be filled. Let every mountain be high. Here is your God.
Let us pray. May these mysteries, O Lord, in which we have participated, profit us, we pray. For even now, as we walk amid passing things, you teach us by them to love the things of heaven and hold fast to what endures. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Our Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God. In your green hymnals, number 299.
Come, come, Emmanuel, Son of God, appear. Heaven and earth rejoice, salvation.